Hello friends, welcome to CSAT Mantra. CSAT made easy and affordable. Welcome to our daily dose of solved questions. For more solved questions and concepts, kindly join our Telegram channel. To enroll in our course, kindly visit csatmantra.com. Both the links are given below in the description. Let x square plus y square is equal to 1, u square plus v square is equal to 1, and xu plus yv is equal to 0. Then these three equations, we have to find out which one of them is are true. We have solved similar problems in our lectures, my friends. I told always, whenever you see variables, that is A, B, C, X, Y, Z, alpha, beta, gamma. Whenever you see the variables in problems, then always think of without loss of generality concept. We call these items as variables because their values are not fixed, my friends. Whereas 1, 2, 3, these are constants, okay? Constants, because 1 is 1 only, it cannot be any other value, my friends. 2 is 2 only, 3 is 3 only, that's why we call them as constant. Whereas A can be anything, its value is not fixed. A can be 1, A can be 2, A can be anything, that is not given in the problem. That's why we call them as variables. So whenever you see the variables in the problems, always think of without loss of generality concept. This is clear, right? Now, what is without loss of generality concept? This concept means without loss, without violating any general rule given in the problem. There are some rules that will be given in the problem, right? The conditions, without violating them, you are solving the problem by trial and error method, my friends, okay? That is substitution method. You will be substituting these variables with simple values. Again, I am telling simple values. Minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3 or minus 2, minus 3, my friends. Very simple values. Always start from 0, 1 or minus 1. So, in without loss of generality concept problems, you will be using trial and error method. That is substitution method. You will be substituting simple values, these values, and checking whether these values satisfies these conditions or not. If they satisfies, okay, then you will be generalizing the problem. They will satisfy for every other value. So this is how you solve the problems using without loss of generality concept. You have to keep three things in mind, my friends. First, you have to see the variables and see if there are any conditions given for them, and then substitute these simple values in the place of these variables, okay? Now see, in this problem, I have variables x, y, u, v, so without loss of generality concept. Now, there are no rules, no conditions given for these variables, my friends. Nothing is mentioned about them, whether x is greater than 1 or y is less than 0. Nothing is mentioned about them. So you are free to take any values for these variables. This is clear, right? So variables and then conditions, okay? Now simple values for these variables, my friends, okay? So that these values will satisfy these equations. Now see, x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0 will satisfy this equation. 1 square plus 0 square is 1, my friends, okay? And u is equal to 0, v is equal to 1 will satisfy this equation. See, 0 square plus 1 square is equal to 1. Now see, x is equal to 1, u is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, v is equal to 1, okay? xu is 1 into 0 plus yv, 0 into 1, this is 0 plus 0, this is equal to 0. So these values will satisfy this equation also. I have not taken u is equal to 1, v is equal to 0 because x into u, that is 1 into 1, y into v, that is 0 into 0, this is 1 plus 0, this is equal to 1. Third equation is not getting satisfied, my friends. That's why I have not taken u is equal to 1. I took u is equal to 0 and v is equal to 1 so that the third equation is satisfied. This is clear, right? Now let's substitute these values in these three equations and see which of them is true, okay? So x square plus u square, okay? X square is 1 square, u square is 0 square, that is 1 plus 0, this is equal to 1. As this equation is true, Now y square plus v square, y square is 0 square, v square is 1 square, this is 0 plus 1, this is equal to 1. Yes, this equation is also true. Now xy plus uv, xy is 1 into 0, uv, okay, 0 into 1, this is 0 plus 0, this is equal to 0. This equation is also true. So our answer is C, my friends. This question is asked in CAPF. Assistant Commandant 2019 paper, my friends. Very easy question. You can solve it in 10 seconds without using pen and paper. So whenever you see variables, think of without loss of generality concepts. See the conditions given in the problem and then take the values according to them. Substitute these values in the given asked statements or equations and then generalize the problem, my friends. Now let's solve this problem in conventional method. In conventional method also you can solve this problem in 10 to 15 seconds. Now see, in this equation we have x term and u term. So in the given equations we have to find a equation which is having x and u term, my friends. You have to simplify that one so that you will be getting a equation in x and u. Here we don't have x and u, here we don't have x and u, here we have x and u terms, my friends. Okay, so I am writing xu as minus yv. I took yv this side, my friends, so that's why minus yv. Now here we have squares, right? X square plus u square. So we need to get squares here. So I am squaring this equation on both sides. So xu whole square is equal to minus yv whole square. This is x square u square is equal to y square v square. I want the equation in x square and u square only, right? So let's eliminate y square and v square. From equation 1, we can write y square as 1 minus x square. From equation 2, we can write v square as 1 minus u square. Now we got y square value in terms of x square, v square value in terms of u square. Let's substitute these in this equation so that we'll be getting a equation in x square and u square, my friends. Okay? Now x square u square is equal to y square is 1 minus x square, v square is 1 minus u square. So 1 into 1 is 1 minus u square minus x square plus x square u square. I'm just expanding this one. Okay, this is equal to x square u square. So this term and this term cancelled out both sides. So x square plus u square is equal to 1. So we got first equation, my friends. This is true. Now in this equation, if you substitute x square and u square value, x square value is 1 minus y square, u square is 1 minus v square. If you substitute these values, you will be getting this equation, my friends. You no need to solve it. Just by looking, you can say, by substituting these values, you can get this equation, my friends. No need to solve it. Because it's similar to what we have solved for equation 1, right? Now once these two equations are true, then you can say xy plus uv is equal to 0, because when these two equations are true, you have said xu plus yv is equal to 0. So when these two equations are true, you can definitely say xy plus uv is equal to 0. You don't need to solve for that. Just looking at these equations and comparing, you can say this equation is also true, my friends. Okay, so this is how you solve this problem in conventional method. Learning conventional method along with the shortcut method is very important, my friends. Okay, sometimes shortcut methods may not work. In that case, you have to go for conventional method. Okay, so this is how you solve this problem, my friends.